inspiration for others, but not everyone should feel called to live a life of poverty, especially the abject poverty that cramps the development of our talents and our ability to serve others. It is very difficult to balance spiritual and material needs. The law of polarity suggests that either extreme wealth or extreme poverty is not natural. Obsession with wealth and self-imposed poverty can both strip the human spirit of its ability to develop and evolve. As witches, we try to live somewhere in the golden mean. It is just as wrong to give away our last penny as it is to give away nothing at all. Each of us is at a particular place on a spiritual path, and each of us must live in a material world at the same time. We must each strike a proper balance so that we can flourish as both spiritual and physical beings. Many years ago, I worried about charging a fee to people who controlled and enrolled in my witchcraft classes. Like many others in the craft, I thought that accepting a fee was somehow compromising my moral responsibility to share my knowledge with others. At the same time, however, I spent many sleepless nights worrying about how I would pay my bills. After struggling financially for some time, I realized that if I wanted to continue teaching, I would have to charge money. I surprisingly learned that the thing happened, and my students seemed to value the classes even more and took them more seriously. They also demanded a better quality of teaching, since they were paying for it now with hard-earned money. I became a better teacher, more keenly aware of the exchange being made between my students and me. They paid tuition. I taught the craft. Furthermore, my self-esteem was heightened when I realized that people were willing to pay money for what I had to offer. My tuition fees have never been exorbitant, but I am always stuffed and touched by the students in every class for whom the fee is a real sacrifice. For them, it is worthwhile. And I realize my responsibility. And I realize my responsibility to make it worthwhile for them. Read through the following statements about wealth and money. Many of them are part of our so-called folk wisdom. Notice your immediate intuitive response to each one. Don't spend too much time analyzing them. Just read each and see if any of them agrees or disagrees with you. Money seekers are hedonists. Money corrupts. Money is the root of all evil. You don't need money to be happy. The best things in life are free. Rich people tend to be corrupt and selfish. To walk a spiritual path, you should give away your possessions. If you tend to agree with these comments, you may be creating psychic roadblocks to prosperity. You may be rooting yourself in attitudes that will prevent you from making and moving ahead in your job, or receiving financial windfalls, or simply making enough money to live comfortably or provide for your family. You can neutralize these attitudes and reprogram your thinking. Money magic and prosperity spells will protect the material comforts and the wealth that you need, and at the same time, teach you to accept them. In the meantime, repeat the following affirmations until they become part of your consciousness. Soon, they will draw into your life whatever you need to improvise your financial situation. Money enables us to obtain the goods parking space or $1 million. The only limits to your witch magic are those you impose yourself. And I have come to the conclusion, after dealing with all kinds of people over the years, that all our limitations come from a lack of self-esteem. Once again, self-esteem and proper self-love are at the core of successful magic and successful living. The Pink Star Meditation on page 193 is a prerequisite for all money magic spells, for it will bolster self-esteem and create a strong self-image. It will strengthen your belief that it is correct to have personal wealth and health and to share them with others. Remember that every time that you say, "I believe," it must be turned to an "I know." It is one thing to believe something and another thing to actually know it. Sometimes projecting the needed money can work apparent miracles. Years ago, when my daughter and I moved to our new home, money was tight. We stopped in a restaurant for lunch, and when I looked at the menu, I realized that we would not be able to afford the lunch because I would be about $10 short. Jody, who was about 9 years old at the time, felt sorry for me, and I could tell by the question in her eyes that she wanted to help. I told her we would need $10 more if we were going to order. She looked down at her plate, and I knew that she was projecting for the money. Suddenly, a $10 bill floated down out of the air and onto her plate. The waitress who was standing there saw the bill and our surprise at the same time, but she said nothing. We looked around to see if someone had dropped it by mistake, but we were sitting at a table in the middle of the room, and no one was near us. A magic wish list. To make magic wish lists, sit back and think about the material things that you need for about 15 minutes. Really evaluate them, discarding what is not truly necessary, selecting only those that you must have. Then write out a spell asking in the name of a higher source for the items that you need. List them and read the list over and over out loud. By reciting the list, you are charging your intentions with vocal vibrations, and the projection is fortified with magical energy. Burn the list or carry it with you, or keep it in a place that holds magic for you. The crystal moon list. If you project a list in conjunction with the phases of the moon, what I call a crystal moon list, you will have even more chance of seeing your dreams come true. Begin the spell on the first full moon after your birthday each year. Compile the list only of material objects that you want or need. Intangibles like love and happiness can be projected by using other meditations. Recite the list out loud, asking in the name of the higher intelligence that makes sense to you to grant your requests. Years ago, I was doing psychic consulting work for a large corporation in England, during which time my daughter, Jody, had projected for a Rolex watch on her crystal moon list. When I arrived back in Salem, since I had already received my stipend, I wondered what it could be. It was an extra gift, a Rolex watch. Since I have never been able to wear watches because of my psychic energy, that always seems to break the timing mechanisms, I decided to give it to Jody as a present, not knowing that just days before, she had projected for it on her crystal moon list. How happily surprised we both were. Herbal prosperity spells. Herbs ruled by Jupiter will draw money and prosperity. See the list of plants on page 311. Cloves and cinnamon can be charged for a spell and sometimes added to foods. Skullcap and tonka beans are not edible but can be carried or worn in a royal blue or purple bag to bring luck, money, and influence. Valerian will attract money. Red clover tops draw customers to your business, and mistletoe wins success, fortune. job applications and any correspondence that deals with money. Mix the ingredients in a stainless steel or enamel pot. Do not use an iron pot except for protection potions. Iron will neutralize and diffuse the energy. An aluminum pot will poison the liquid. Charge each of the following ingredients: 2 cups of spring water, 1/8 ounce of heliotrope oil, heather herb or heather oil, cinnamon sticks, gold jewelry, not gold plate or silver jewelry, 2 tablespoons of sea salt, chamomile tea bag, so that the leaves stay filled project for what you want, saying, "These candles bring me wealth and riches." When finished, extinguish the flame with a spoon, candle stuffer, or your fingers, not your breath, which will change the spell. Begin this spell on a Sunday, a Thursday, or a Friday, as these days honor the Sun, Jupiter, and Venus, respectively. Relight the candles every night until they are completely burnt down. Daily repetition will increase the spell's effectiveness and your own prosperity consciousness. A word about gambling and magic. I have always enjoyed playing the Massachusetts State Lottery, but I have never won megabucks. It is exciting to take part in an event which thousands of people are projecting for the same end result. A large number of participants evens out the psychic odds and makes the game fair. Lotteries and other games can be fun, always to use your energies to manifest money. They should, however, be played in moderation. Also, I don't believe in luck. The people who win do so for a purpose. Everything comes out from self-directed energy and spells, and is for a specific purpose, even though we may not always know what that purpose is. Witches don't have any monopoly on the lottery, and to my knowledge, are not concerned with the money market. Most of the people who win are not witches, but their winnings come from their own projections, just as those who do magic. When it comes to important things in life, like financial security, we can all project powerfully. The only guidelines I would advise for gambling and games of chance is to